Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell. That always helps. And if you would, before the video is done, hit the like button. All right, guys. If you guys are familiar with this channel, you know the list is the crowdsourced wisdom of the Dogumentary TV community. Creating and generating a list for which hopefully most creating lists that other dog lovers may find useful. In this video, we're going to be talking about dogs for beginners. So the Dogumentary TV community has generated a list of 10 top dog breeds for beginners. Again, I'm going to give you your recommendations, and I personally am going to give you my thoughts. It could be some critiques, it could be some cosigns, but I'm going to tell you how I feel about what you guys have presented as the best dogs for beginners. All right, let's jump into this list. At number 10, you guys have the Chihuahua. We have definitely started off on the wrong foot. Chihuahua, not anything that I would ever recommend to anybody. I mean, they're cool dogs, I guess. I just feel like we have so many horrible owners of the breed that, you know, it really reflects poorly on the breed itself. At number 9, 442 of you voted for the English Bulldog. Not a bad pick, definitely a low energy dog. I would say most reasonable people should be able to deal with an English Bulldog. They can be a bit stubborn, and you do want to make sure you do your research, because they have some medical issues that you may want to make sure that you don't have problems with. Like, you know, you don't want to keep them out in the sun too long. You don't want to overexert them. You want to do some research, but I think at number 9, the English Bulldog is a good dog for beginners. At number 8, you guys have the Basset Hound. The Basset Hound received 476 votes. Again, another low energy dog, relatively chill. I think this dog as well can be a little bit stubborn, and it is a hound. It's a slow moving hound, so it's cool. I mean, if you guys like it, at number 8, it's a good dog for beginners. It's not a dog that I would put on my list, but let's move on. At number 7, you guys have the Boston Terrier. The Boston Terrier received 680 votes. I like this pick. It's a small dog, a lot of character, a lot of spunk. Not a dog that can do a terrible amount of damage to even small children. It's not. It is a terrier though, so you got to be careful. But for the most part, you know, I think it's an easy breed to care for and easy breed to maintain. At number 6, you guys voted for the French Bulldog, 748 votes. I like this pick. I think that French Bulldogs are great little dogs. They're great with kids. They're very easy to manage. Don't need a whole lot of exercise. Kind of like the English Bulldog though, you want to make sure you keep them in a nice cool environment. You don't want to overexert them. They do have this mush face and can deal with heat and exhaustion issues. Beyond that, you know, they're great little dogs, make for good watchdogs. They'll let you know when someone's coming, that's for sure. At number 5, you guys voted for the Standard Poodle. The Standard Poodle received 1,056 votes. I like this as well. I think Standard Poodles are great dogs, highly intelligent, very calm, typically calm. You want to make sure that you are, I would say, getting a Standard Poodle, depending on what you want to do with it. You want to make sure that you're getting a Standard Poodle from a companion breeder. There are poodles that are that do field work, and they might be a little bit more difficult based on their energy level and their intelligence. But for the most part, I think the Standard Poodle is a great dog at number 5. Number 4, got a bit of controversy here. You guys have voted the American Bully. It received 1,088 votes. I personally love the American Bully. It might even be higher on my list. I understand the breed community is a bit of a mess, but there are people who breed healthy, well-balanced American Bullies. I mean, you get a hold of a good one, low energy, even tempered Velcro dog. I mean, these dogs are amazing. They're not going to, I mean, and like, obviously, if you have an active lifestyle, it might not be the dog for you. But if you are someone, a family, you only want to walk 1 or 2 miles a day, you don't want a whole lot of barking, you don't want a whole lot of animal aggression, American Bully is perfect, but you got to get the right kind, because the community, to be honest, can be a mess, and the breed is not quite dialed in perfectly, or even, it can be a mess in some places, okay? So, obviously, you got to make sure you find a good breeder if you want to get yourself an American Bully, but I love the American Bully as for beginners. At number three, you guys have the Beagle. I don't know what's going on with the Beagle. I just saw something the other day. I know it has something to do with medical testing and all that. I'm going to need to do some more research on that. But evidently, there's a lot of Beagles that need to be rescued from these, for whatever the crisis is that's going on right now. But in regards to the Beagle as a dog for beginners, again, it's a good dog, even tempered, not a ton of dog aggression, not a ton of aggression, period. Not necessarily a low energy dog, but not a super high energy dog. It's a smaller dog, so very easy to care for, to move around with. I like the Beagle at number three. At number two, you guys have the Golden Retriever. Obviously, you know, every family, every American portrait, every American family portrait, you know, the cliche is the Golden Retriever. Obviously, it's a great family dog. It's an intelligent companion, a very even-tempered breed. Has been pretty much bred consistently for a long time. Not hard to find a well-balanced Golden Retriever. There are field retrievers, though, so you might want to be careful, because obviously a field retriever is going to have a lot more energy and it's going to be a little bit more to deal with. And the same can be said for our number one breed, which is the Labrador Retriever. The Golden Retriever received 1,440 votes. The Labrador Retriever received 1,880 votes. Now, obviously, you know, the Labrador Retriever, I think for 30, 40 years now running, has always been the most popular dog in the United States, and for good reason. Very easy to own, very loving, very caring. It's kind of a Swiss army of dogs. You want to go hiking 5-10 miles a day, you can get a Labrador for that. If you want to just want to walk 2 or 3 miles a day, a Labrador can do that. Labradors and Goldens, they are retrievers, so you can burn a lot of calories on your dog by spending 20-30 minutes in the backyard just throwing something and having the dog retrieve it. I think that's one of the great things about retrievers, right? You know, you personally don't have to travel far to engage the dog's primary instincts. All right, guys, so there you go. That's your list with the top 10 best dogs for beginners. All right, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.